chapter 9 of aviation topics in the book Aviation and Business Management. You know, there are many departments in the airports. So every airport has many departments, and in these departments, what are the functions and the roles are there, we'll be discussing in this video. So starting with the air traffic services, they are known as ATS. You know, air traffic control, which is ATC, which we know in general, are a part of the air traffic services. So ATC will be providing the ATS services. So this is the job role or the responsibility of an ATC. So what they will be doing is, the air traffic control service is actually divided into three parts. So what are those three? One is the area control service, second is the approach control service, and third is the aerodrome control service. To understand this better, let us take a bigger region. Let's say this is the southern region of India. So there are so many aircrafts that are flying in this region. So all the response, so all the controlling of this flight movement within this big area is the area control service. Now next is the approach control service. Let's say you are here near Hyderabad. So surrounding the vicinity of Hyderabad, let's say smaller area will be defined, and this which is nearer to the Hyderabad airport, then this is known as the approach. Let's say among the all these aircraft, if some aircraft is want to land in this Hyderabad airport, so what it will be doing is, it will be approaching the Hyderabad and will try to land. So ATC will define some area, and once that flight enters into that area and is trying to land at the Hyderabad airport, then when the flight is in this region, then the air traffic control has to provide the services to this flight, then that is known as approach control service. Now the third one is aerodrome control. Now let's say the flight that wanted to land in Hyderabad is now just above the, you can say just above the ATC control, or it's nearer to the airport of Hyderabad, let's say within a distance of 25 nautical miles. So now it is just about to land. So, or it is just about to take off from here. So when it is in such a small, it is very close to this tower, or the, you can say aerodrome is the correct term. Let's say Hyderabad aerodrome or Chennai aerodrome, whichever aerodrome is there or whichever airport is there, it has come so close and it is about to access that airport, then the flights in these regions are being controlled, and the services that are being provided to that region by the ATC comes under the aerodrome control services. So you can see, when it is in the near to the airport, then that is under aerodrome control. Let's say Hyderabad. Approach control is, let's say it is in the Karnataka or nearer to the, it is coming from Bangalore to Hyderabad and is very close to Hyderabad, then that comes under the approach. Whereas area is even bigger. Let's say in the entire southern region, the ATC is controlling all this, then that comes under the area control service. So the part of the ATC is, their duties and responsibilities are divided into these three areas: area control, approach control, and the aerodrome control. So what are the objectives of the air traffic services? So now we know that they are providing these three services. Next is, what are the objectives? What is their duty? What they have to do while they are on the job? You know, they have to prevent the collisions between aircraft. So many aircraft are flying in this region or in this area or near the aerodrome. So what they have to do is, they have to control the movement of each aircraft so that they should ensure that there is no collision between the aircrafts. So this ATC has to ensure. And also, one more thing is, prevent collisions between aircraft on maneuvering area and the obstructions on that area. In the previous video, we have also discussed that near the runway and the taxiway, this which is known as a maneuvering area. So what happens is, in between, let's say some aircraft is landing, and in that some aircraft is taking off. So they have to prevent the collisions in between these also. They have to ensure that no collisions happen in the maneuvering area. So that is also one of the objective of the ATC duty personnel. Next is, expedite and maintain the orderly flow of traffic. There are so many aircraft, so they have to control the traffic. That is what ATC says, traffic control, you know. So they have to maintain the air traffic. expedite means they have to make it efficient and they have to do it as good as possible. So these are the general objectives of an ATC. They have to ensure that there is no collision between aircrafts or in the maneuvering area, and they have to maintain a systematic order flow of the air traffic in that service area. Let it be area, approach or aerodrome, depending on the services providing, he has to ensure those three things, that no collision has to happen. Now apart from that, there is one more thing, which is a flight information service. You know, this information is like they have to provide useful information from the safe and efficient conduct of the flights. Now the, let's say this is the area and now the flight is here. So the flight here, the pilot will contact the ATC. So now this ATC has to provide the useful information, let's say weather conditions and from which runway he has to use. So many things the pilot needs to have. So this information ATC has to provide. So that comes under the category of flight information service. That is, he has to provide the advice and information useful for the safe and efficient conduct of flights. And next is the alerting service. So this is a general day-to-day routine, but then let's say in the event when an aircraft goes missing or something has happened to the aircraft, let's say some accident has happened in the airport, then what they have to do is they have to do the alerting service. Means they have to identify and they have to notify the other organizations. Let's say if some accident has happened, they have to contact with the fire department, they have to contact with the medical team, they have to coordinate with the security team. So such are alerting. In the event of emergency or alerts, they have to do some alerting service. To notify the appropriate organization regarding aircraft in need of search and rescue when the aircraft has lost, and assist organizations such required. So you can just remember that ATC provides a flight information service, alerting service is sufficient. So these are actually job responsibilities of ATC. They have to ensure that no collision between aircraft happens in the air or in the maneuvering area, and they have to maintain the orderly traffic. This is in general the description of ATC, what ATC does. Next is airport rescue and firefighting. I have made a separate video on the ARFF. You can find that in the description. In general, they have to ensure that no fire catches in the airport. They have to take all the safety precautions. If at all some accident happens, they have to ensure that no damage has caused to the airport infrastructure or to the personnel. That what it says. I'll just go quickly, you know, to provide the level of protection at the airport according to the designated category. Every airport has a category which is designated by ICAO. So they have to provide the ARFF services according to that category. Next is the fire prevention and control of the ATC tower, terminal building, technical building, cargo and other airport infrastructures. They have to ensure that in all these areas no fire happens, and if at all it happens, they have to protect them from damaging and take action as soon as possible. For doing that, they need to conduct some emergency exercises like full-scale emergency exercise, partial exercise, building evacuation, some drills. So they'll be doing some drills so that they are always upkeeping their procedures and they know what all to do. So it's like a practice that they have to do regularly. If some fire happens, they have to conduct an investigation and ensure that no such thing happen in the future. If at all something happens, they have to coordinate with the city fire brigade and the industrial fire services which are in the vicinity of the airport. You can find more details on ARFF in my other video. I'll share the link in the description. Next is, we'll move ahead to the airport operations. You know, this is AO. So what the AO will do, what are the job responsibilities of a junior executive airport operations? So some of the functions of the airport operations department are, they have to ensure the serviceability of all passenger and operational facility all the time. So once you are in the terminal building or the passenger building, you have to ensure all the services that are there with respect to the passenger. They have to ensure that they are upkeeping and they are always working. So this is the main job of the airport operations. The passenger services should be always working, and they have to ensure the passenger should not face any difficulties while at the airport. So all the things. So what are the things? One is the airside management. You know, terminal building is there. This is the airside. This is the city side. So they have to ensure that the airside apron. This airside management, you can say apron management. Terminal management is a basic building, passenger building. So these they have to take care. So all the services that are there, facilities that are there in this, they have to manage. and they have to ensure the serviceability. Serviceability means they are working. They are in working condition. Next is, if at all there is a AOCC, is the apron, is operational control center in bigger airports. What happens is apron is big, so a separate department will be there, AOCC. So sometimes airport operation department handle that. This is in bigger airports like Bangalore, Delhi and all, we have AOCC. Whereas in smaller airports, we don't have this AOCC. So we need not discuss much. Next is the safety management and coordination with other airports. So they have to also take care of safety, and they have to always do some coordination with other airports. Okay. So this is one of the important functions. Next is one few other are plan and project requirements regarding construction and upgradation of aerodrome. If the airport has to be expanded, then they have to plan. So all these things they will be doing. Airport operations team, planning and construct upgradation, everything. Then is DGCA. DGCA, as we know, is the regulatory authority in India. So they have to coordinate with DGCA so that to ensure airport infrastructure is safe. Handling of VIP moments, let's say some prime minister is coming or some chief minister is coming to the airport, then they have to handle all the procedures and protocols that are need to be carried out during the VIP visits. The next is movement and aircraft emergencies. If something emergency happens, like the hijacking of aircraft or some accident happens, then these are emergencies. So they have to ensure that they have to take care in these situations. So this is the airport operations functions jobs. Or against responsibilities. Next is immigration. You know, in India, there is a separate department known as the Bureau of Immigration, which is known as BOI. It was set up in 1971 by the government of India to undertake immigration function in the country. So what this BOI is, BOI is actually headed by Commission of Immigration, and they are assisted by local foreign regional offices. These are regional offices, whereas Commission is the head. So they'll be carrying out the immigration facility at the airport. So what they'll be doing at the airport? You know, they'll be doing an immigration clearance. They'll be giving a visa on arrival. They will be doing a grant of temporary landing permit or temporary landing facilities. Clearance of deportees. You can just remember these terms. You know, these are general terms with respect to immigration. If somebody is coming from other country into our country, then our country needs to have all the details of the passengers. They need to have visa, they need to have a clearance, so many things. So these are taken care of by the immigration department. Next is in international airports. Nowadays, it's a mandatory that they need to have a health department as well. So what happens is, under the international health regulations and the part of statutory requirements, which are mandatory requirements, the airport health organizations, they have to perform the various public health functions at the airport. So what are these functions? You know, now during the corona time, you know, all the passengers were screened for thermal screening. So this was done by the health department. So some of the functions are like health screening of the international passengers. If the passenger is having coronavirus or some other diseases, so that screening can be done for all the incoming as well as outgoing passengers from and to the airport. Next is, if at all the passenger has been identified as a corona positive, let's say, then they have to perform the quarantine and isolation of passengers. Similarly, vector control in the aircraft and at the airport's vaccination, if some yellow fever or something is there. So these are some of the functions, you know, it depends from airport to airport. We cannot generalize them. Some of them are in international airports and some of them are not in India. But you can just remember, they have to perform the sanitization. They have to ensure the water quality and the food and the hygiene. If some dead body is coming, they have to ensure the dead body clearance. So anything that is related to health of the passenger, then all these things will be taken care of by the health department. Next is a customs department. You know, customs department, we have a central board of excises customs. There is a department which comes under the Department of Revenue, which is under the Ministry of Finance. So these provide the customs services at the airport. So you have to remember that CBEC is the one which provides the custom services at the airport. So what they'll be doing is, so first of all, the airport needs to have a custom clearance. You know, only when an airport has a customs clearance, only then they can do the international service. I mean, international airport can be happen only when there's a custom department. So it's a mandatory. The airport operator, let's say AAI or the GMR airport or the Adani airport. So they have to obtain a clearance certificate from the Department of Revenue for the provision of customs services. So that's what I said. They need to have a clearance certificate. Only when they have the certificate, they can perform these things. So what are the functions that are being services that are being provided by the customs department? Some of them are walkthrough channel, customs control, the walkthrough channel, custom control, the baggage examination centers, in the green and red channel of custom control of detained goods. If some goods that are banned or something which is illegal, then they have to do a control of these things when they're coming inside the country of misheld baggage. Sometimes smugglers or somebody, they can leave. Something happens, sometimes thefts will happen, many things. So everything can be categorized as mishandled. So they have to do a control and keep a check of all these things. Then valuables, if somebody is bringing some gold or some more cash, then he has to bring in the country. Then these things they have to control. Reshipment of goods, like many mobile phones, they cannot bring. There's a restriction on that when a person is traveling from US or foreign countries. So these things are all defined. So these things will be taken care of the customs department. Upon the arrival of the international passengers, they have to go through the customs department. You know, we have a separate chapter on the passenger journey. There we have discussed where the exact customs department is and what they'll be doing. For time, you can remember these things. Issuance of export certificates. So, you know, these are some of the important departments that are working in the airports. So if you have any doubts or you have any questions, you can comment in the video. I'll be happy to clarify them and share my knowledge as much as possible on them. So if you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos. And thank you for watching.